In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware free worksheet under the Geometry tab, Angle Pair Relationships. In the previous video, we quickly went over linear pair, vertical angle, complementary angle, and adjacent angles, and we're using those definitions to figure out the measure of angle B. In number 13, we can recognize that angle B and 35 degrees form a linear pair. Linear pairs share a common vertex, a common side, and their non-common sides are opposite rays. Opposite rays share the same endpoint and go opposite directions. So therefore, that angle will be 180 degrees. So B plus 35 degrees equals 180 degrees. We're going to subtract 35 degrees from both sides to get that B is equal 145 degrees. So essentially taking away 35 degrees from 180, since that was already accounted for. Let's move on to number 14. On number 14, we can recognize that we have a complementary angles form 90 degrees. So B plus 29 degrees will equal 90 degrees. So subtract 29 degrees from both sides to get that B is equal to 61 degrees. And number 15, B is an adjacent angle to 94 degrees. We know that an entire circle is equal to 360 degrees. So 360 degrees is going to equal that angle B plus 94 degrees plus our other measurement of 243 degrees. Combining like terms on the right-hand side, so our degrees, 94 degrees plus 243 degrees will give us 337 degrees. Then we'll subtract 337 degrees from both sides to get that B is equal to 360 minus 337, which is 23 degrees. In number 16, we're trying to find the measure of angle B. You can see that angle B and 49 degrees form a linear pair since they share a common vertex, common side, and their non-common sides are opposite rays. Therefore, B plus 49 degrees will equal 180 degrees. Subtracting 49 degrees, we will get that B is equal to 131 degrees. And that's our solution for number 16. In number 17, we can see that angle B and 90 degrees are vertical angles because they are non-adjacent angles formed by intersecting lines. And we know that vertical angles share the same measure, so B is also 90 degrees. In number 18, again, we can see that B and 73 are vertical angles and therefore have the same measure, so B is 73 degrees. In the last four problems on our worksheet, numbers 19 through 22, we're going to find the value of X. So you can see that this angle, 3x plus 18 degrees, and this angle of 93 degrees share a common vertex, common side, and their non-common sides are opposite rays. So therefore, 3x plus 18 degrees plus 93 degrees equals 180 degrees. I'm going to start by combining my like terms, my 18 and my 93. So I have 3x plus 18 plus 93 is going to give me 111, and that is going to be equal to 180. So when I subtract 111 from both sides, I'll be left with 3x on the left, and that's going to be equal to 69. My next step is to divide by 3, and when I do so, I get that x is equal to 23. So x is 23 in number 19. In number 20, knowing that a full circle equals 360 degrees, I'm going to add 296 to 29 and then subtract that from 360 degrees to get the angle that contains the x. So 29 plus 296 is equal to 325. So 29 plus 296 equals 325. If I take that away from 360, 360 minus 325 gives me 35 degrees. So I have that 35 degrees is equal to my angle that's left, which is x minus 24. So I'll just add 24 to both sides to get that 59 is equal to x. So you can see I did mental math beforehand, and then I figured out that 35 degrees was going to be equal to x minus 24. So then I solved for x. In number 21, you can see that 62 degrees forms a vertical angle with 2 plus 3x. And since vertical angles are equivalent in measure, we'll have that 62 degrees is equal to 2 plus 3x. So all I have to do is subtract 2 from both sides to get that 60 equals 3x. And then my last step is to divide by 3 to get that 20 is equal to x. And lastly, number 22. I have that this 90 degree angle forms a linear pair with these two angles. And I know that 180 minus 90 is equal to 90. So I know that 40 degrees plus 6x plus 2 also has to equal 90 degrees. I'm going to start by subtracting 40 degrees. I'll have 6x plus 2, and that's going to be equal to 50. I'll subtract 2 to get that 6x equals 48, and then when I divide by 6, I get that x is equivalent to 8. So 8 is my final solution in number 22. And that wraps up the angle pair relationships worksheet. Please feel free to click that like button, and also, while you're at it, click the subscribe button. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below.